Hello and welcome to HP Calcs. I'm Rick, and today we're going to have a quick look at how to use trig functions on the Texas Instruments TI-30X2S calculator. To do this, we'll be using the sine, cosine, and tangent keys that look like this and are located along here, as well as the second function key, looks like this, is up here, and the x to the power of negative 1 or x inverse key looks like this, and is located right here beneath the sine key. Now, all these examples will be using sine, cosine, and tangent, etc., of degrees. So first thing we want to do is make sure our calculator is set to degrees. You can tell that it is if you see a DEG down here at the bottom of the screen. If it's not, you can press the DRG key here, so it brings up this menu. We want to then move our cursor over until we get to the DEG, and press equals, and that will convert our calculator into degrees mode. All right, so for the basics, if we wanted to just find the sine of 30 degrees, we would type it as you would write it. So sine 30 equals 0.5. Yep. And cosine of 30 equals 0.8660, etc. Looks good. And the tan 30 equals 0.5774, rounded. All right, those are easy enough, but what if we wanted to find the cosecant, secant, or cotangent of a number? Well, to do that, what we do is actually inverse the result of the corresponding function. So for cosecant, we would have to inverse the sine of 30. If we want to find the cosecant of 30, we go sine 30 equals, get to that 0.5, and then we use this x to the power of negative 1 key, or inverse key. There we go. And we see we get a cosecant of 30 degrees is equal to 2. For secant, we do the same with cos, so we go cos of 30 equals 0.8660, and then inverse that equals to get a secant of 30 degrees equal to 1.547, etc. Cotangent, we use tan, so we go tan of 30 equals 0.5774, and then inverse that to get a cotangent of 30 degrees equal to 1.7321. We can also do arcsin, arccos, and arctan on this calculator, which are represented by the blue numbers above the sine, cos, and tan, or the second function of these keys. This is used for going from the 0.5 and figuring out how many degrees we use sine on to get to that. So basically taking this in reverse. If we had 0.5 and wanted to arcsin it, we would press second function, sine, so that we get sine to the negative 1 there, and then enter our 0.5, press equals, and see this brings us back to 30 degrees. For our cos, again, second function, cos, and remember for this one we got 0.8660 equals, and we see this brings us back to what would round to 30 degrees. And for arctan, again, second function, tan, and remember we got 0.5774 equals. And again, since we rounded this, we're not quite getting 30 degrees, but we get what would round to it. So we get the arctan of 0.5774 is equal to 30 degrees. All right, hope this helps out there, everybody, and good luck on those tests.